Hello, everyone. This is everyone's favorite YouTube author, Cody Lee, author of Cruel and Beautiful, Eye of the Dragon, Rabbit Hole, and King Dia. Not to mention the upcoming Lauren Frey. Please stay. Please be excited for that. And here we are with some Elden Ring gameplay. Now, I got a lot of requests to give my thoughts on Elden Ring. And to be perfectly honest, I had not seen any gameplay of it. I hadn't spent any time on it. I was too busy playing SMT5 and Pokemon and, like, legit, like, I think Batman Arkham Asylum I was playing around the time this dropped. This came out on the 4th. Wow, it's been that long. Well, this has a lot of people hyped, and I am really, really interested in seeing what the biggest release of next year is going to be. I'm going into this completely unbiased, completely blind, going to give you my exact thoughts on Elden Ring and From Software. Oh man, I can't wait to see how this has evolved since Dark Souls.
Hello, everyone.
A PC build still in development. Oh no, so it's inferior to the Switch version.
Of our new action RPG, Elden Ring. We hope it helps to convey a little of this title's mood and gameplay.
So we're gonna see some gameplay. Oh man, none of this trailer bullshit. What?
Huh? Is set here in the lands between.
It looks exactly like Dark Souls. Exactly like it, with the armor and the weapon, and yeah, there's the bonfire.
Occasionally, grace will manifest rays of God.
It's not exactly a bonfire, but it's the same thing. Yeah, you can have a horse.
We're free to choose whether to follow the
open environment.
Or head off to explore in a different direction.
But open world would not suit Dark Souls very well, would it? Yeah, the monsters don't look interesting. Yep, they don't come after and attack you. I don't like the environment. It looks just like Dark Souls in an open environment. Oh, a dragon. How different for Dark Souls. Yeah, shit, and this is a pre-release thing. This has to be heavily scripted to make it look as good as possible. Not impressed. Not impressed at all. Yep, same general gameplay, same general combat. Only you have a horse this time. It's going to have the same problem that Twilight Princess had, in which, like, the horseback combat isn't going to be interesting enough to really make the game feel unique or distinct. That dragon didn't put up much of a fight.
Hello.
Yep, the same kind of NPC interactions.
Oh, my stars. I'm so happy to see you. I am Alexander, the singer of the Iron Fist. And as you can see,
you're not Alexander.
Can you help me out of this?
I probably should not make the screen bigger.
Put those doubts to rest. I'll be just fine. And very well trained. Give it your all, I say.
Ah, come on, what are you doing? Bigger. So it's a giant pot. So it's that thing from Banjo-Kazooie. Oh, no.
Well played, good sir. Well played. Though that mighty wand of yours almost spelled the end of me.
Yep, so you interact with the NPCs the same way. Yep, the environment looks generic and boring. I mean, compare this to Breath of the Wild, right? Like, or Xenoblade Chronicles X, or... Like, just compare those vast, interesting, beautiful landscapes to this shit.
The map can prove useful when exploring the world, and is populated by acquiring map fragments.
Yep, yep. Generic open world shit.
We can use markers to customize the map, such as setting reminders for the location of crafting materials or dangerous enemies.
I thought this was a gameplay demonstration, not a map screen demonstration. I know how map systems. Yeah, they ripped off Breath of the Wild! They missed the light system! Come on. Bullshit. Complete crap. How exactly is this better than Breath of the Wild? Can anybody explain that to me? Because it's From Software?
To launch high into the air.
Yep, exactly like the Revali's Gale.
Areas with a great deal of verticality.
Yep, exactly like Breath of the Wild. So it's just like Breath of the Wild, but worse, with Dark Souls combat. So worse. Legit, like real talk, Breath of the Wild has better combat than this. Like, just imagine what you would be doing in Breath of the Wild if you're fighting that dragon. You'd be, like, flying around it. Actually, you don't have to imagine. There are dragon fights in Breath of the Wild. You'd be flying around it, shooting at it in midair, like, using the environment to your advantage, like, not just rolling around like you do here. Shit. Yeah, this doesn't look appealing to me at all. Yeah, pre-order canceled. Shit. So disappointing. Not even worth... Like, my advice for you, if you're looking for a dark fantasy RPG, play Shin Megami Tensei. Play, like, I don't know, Breath of the Wild. Play fucking Bayonetta. Like, shit. There's so many better options on Nintendo consoles. I don't know why you would ever bother with From Software. I thought they would be radically changing the way the game works since it's an open world game, but no, it's the exact same thing that we've always gotten. Just that boring, repetitive, like limited combat. Look at that. Yep, exact same animations. That's the same animation in Dark Souls, the original Dark Souls, I think, with that weapon. Wow. That's right, reusing animations from a decade-old game. That is lazy. And the items have the same glow. The combat's the exact same.
Summon spirits to assist us in battle.
Yep, now you can summon more help, whatever you want.
Spirits vary greatly in type, so we look forward to players experimenting and finding their
So everyone's just going to use the best ones, just like they do in every other From Software game. Yeah, this has to be the last relevant game From Software will ever put out, because... Like, once you go open world, there's really nothing more you can do, at least not right now. Like, nobody's going to be getting hyped for, like, Dark Souls VR or whatever.
Worlds, from cooperative to PvP and invasions.
Hey! Hey, look, listen. It's fucking Navi. Another thing they ripped off from Zelda.
Deadly creatures stalk this forest, so we'll use stealth to avoid detection.
Yeah, that thing you were just running by? I think it's the same creature, right? Yeah, I think they just ran by it. Like, it's a Souls game. It's not going to be hard to just avoid enemies. You know what I mean? Honestly, I think I've seen enough.
We've come across a boss value this area. We'll take it on with the help of our co-op partner.
I don't think I've ever seen the player character get hit in this. So is this easier than other Souls games? It's like a poor man's Monster Hunter Rise. Like, it's the exact same thing, just not as good. Yeah, so there are, like, so many better alternatives on Nintendo consoles already. Why would you ever be looking forward to this? Like, Monster Hunter Rise is getting DLC, like, a couple of months after this. That's gonna be way more exciting than fucking Elden Ring. Breath of the Wild 2 will come out, like, you know, soon after that. So, what exactly are you getting excited for with this?
Mines and other dungeons can be found while out exploring.
Oh, yeah, dungeons like Skyrim. Catacombs or dungeons. Yeah, they even reused. I mentioned Skyrim, immediately see a skeleton. Of course you do. Yeah, there's no personality here, no style, no puzzle solving, no reason to stay engaged. If they kept the object physics, look at the way that a chandelier rolled. Okay, what's back here? What's he gonna find? What is this asshole doing? Like, way to go, guy. He figured out where the treasure was. Uh-oh, it's the waifu. It's Priscilla.
From beyond the fog, I am Melina.
Oh no, Melina. I gotta say, I need more dark fantasy waifus in my life.
I offer you an accord.
We've reached Stormvale.
I don't think I've ever been with an English chick. I've been with an Australian.
Which connects seamlessly to the surrounding.
Been with French girls.
Region.
Japanese girls, obviously. Don't think I've ever been with an English one. I mean, Australian is close enough, I guess, right? I don't know. English women are like ugly as sin, though. Generally speaking, don't care for them at all. I like the accents, though.
It's tightly guarded by hardened old hands. Try the opening right here. The guards don't know about it. You breach the castle undetected.
I don't know. Do I really want to watch all of this? I think I've watched enough, honestly. I think I've seen this bit already, to be honest with you. So that goes against my whole, like, I haven't seen this. Did they not? I swear they released something more recently than this. Was this not what I was supposed to watch? Oh, gameplay preview. No, that's it. Gameplay preview. Was it really 2 weeks ago? Okay. Weird. It feels longer. Well, anyway. Yeah, what a complete joke. What a complete joke that was. That was embarrassingly bad. I don't typically sit through, like, gameplay footage trailers for a good reason, right? Because I'm a Nintendo fan. I only play on Nintendo consoles. I only play Nintendo games. Like, I don't need to watch gameplay footage to see, like, what games I'm excited for. You know what I mean? Like, Metroid Dread, didn't watch any gameplay footage for Breath of the Wild. Yeah, legit, it's been like a 5-year long run of me, like, not really watching any gameplay footage, because there's no reason to, right? This is the first time I've watched, like, a AAA release. Well, not really AAA. Watch, like, a new overhyped release trailer in a long, long time. And, yeah, this is why I've stopped. This is why I don't follow gaming outside of Nintendo. Because there's just nothing there. There's nothing of value. There's nothing worth getting excited for. There's nothing worth paying attention to. Like, unless you're talking about the newest Nintendo exclusive, you may as well not like bother following gaming at all. So, like, Elden Ring, I think it's set to sell well, because we're kind of at that point where people can't really judge from software for not innovating or not evolving and not changing things up. Right now, what the Dark Souls audience want more than anything is, like, more Dark Souls. So they're going to continue milking this IP for as long as they fucking can. And I do expect after Elden Ring is going to, that's going to be when the decline sets in, because from software, they can't innovate, they can't do anything else. They're going to be stuck making, like, dark fantasy action RPGs forever. The point where, like, I think people will get sick of them. You're going to see more with games like Hollow Knight kind of just destroying them at their own game. And I think with time, people will grow to loathe Dark Souls and From Software.